A very good morning to all of you, my dear students. Let us continue our another part of chapter 7, fractions. So today we will study how to reduce a fraction to its lowest term. If you remember, we have done question based on this earlier in exercise 2 also. So in order to reduce a fraction to lowest term, we divide the numerator and denominator by the HCF of the given numbers. Let us try to see it with one example. Example 1 says, reduce 24 by 36 to the lowest terms. Fine. So what we will do? We first find the HCF of 24 and 36. You will find the HCF. There are many methods we have studied to find the HCF. One is your prime factorization method, another is your long division method. Okay, so here they are using the prime factorization method. But when I ask you to reduce a fraction, you can follow any method to find the HCF, either long division method or prime factorization method. So after prime factorization, the factors of 24 are 2 into 2 into 2 into 3. Factors of 36 are 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Now, what is the highest common factor? You have to see which all numbers are common here. So 2 is common, so we will take all the 2s as 1, 2. One more 2 is common, that will be taken as 1, 2, and 3s are common. So these 2 3s will be taken as 1, 3. Now 2 into 2 into 3 will give you 12. So our HCF is 12. Now what we will do? The given fraction was 24 and 36. So you will divide 24 with 12 and 36 with 12. Finally, you will get 2 by 3 as the answer. So 2 by 3 is the reduced form of 24 and 36. Clear? We can reduce a fraction to its lowest terms by dividing the numerator and denominator by their common factors also, till no further division is possible. One more method is to keep on dividing the number with a common number. See one example. Example 3 is from your book. Reduce 16 by 48 to lowest terms. Now here we are not going to find the HCF. If you see, both the numbers are divisible by 2, right? So we will divide both the numbers by 16 divided by 2 and 48 divided by 2. We'll get 8 by 24. Still, you can see they are divided by 2. Again, we are dividing. 8 divided by 2 will give a 4, and 24 divided by 2 will give a 12. Now, again, you can see that these numbers are divisible by 2. So, 4 divided by 2 is a 2, and 12 divided by 2 is a 6. Now, 2 by 6 can further be reduced to 1 by 3. Now, 1 by 3 can't be reduced. So, you will write that the reduced form of 16 by 48 is 1 by 3. For HCF method, when you will find the HCF of 16 and 48, the HCF will come as 16 only. So what you will do, you will divide both the numerator and denominator with HCF and you will get the same answer. Fine. So if it is asked to reduce any number to lowest form, you can follow any method. You can find HCF by any method, or you can keep on dividing both the numerator and denominators with the same till you stop. So let us see some examples from exercise 3 of your book. Question number 1 says, reduce the fractions to their lowest terms by dividing with their HCF. So 16 by 28, I am finding the HCF. I am using the long division method here, and I got the HCF as 4. So the HCF of 16 and 28 is 4. It is done here. It is shown here. You can see it. So what I will do, when I got HCF as 4, I will divide numerator by 4 and denominator by 4. So 16 by 4 will be a 4 and 28 by 4 will be a 7. So your answer is 4 by 7. Question number 1, G part I am doing. 112 by 98. Again, you will find the HCF. You will get the HCF of 112 and 98 as 4. You will divide 112 by 4, you will get a 28. 92 by 4 will give a 23. So the answer is 28 by 23. Question number 2 is, reduce the fractions to their lowest terms by dividing with their common factor. So simply if you see the fraction given is 18 by 27. If you see, both the numbers are divisible by 3. So without finding the HCF, I am dividing 18 by 3 and 27 by 3. On dividing, I got them as 6 by 9. 6 by 9 can further be divided by 3. And finally, the reduced form will be 2 by 3. Okay? So now we have some questions for you as homework. If you see here on exercise 3, all these red boxes are your homework. So your homework is E, C, F, B and D. So 5 questions for you to reduce them to the lowest form. That was all for today, my dear students. Take care. Stay safe. Stay healthy. Thank you.